Welcome, beloved, to our Sunday morning Bible class. Bible says about all words, you're just heard about words, you're condemned. Death and life is the power of the tongue. If you take this by itself, it will appear that then whatever we say should come to pass. It would seem so. Yet in our experience, it has not been so. It has not been so. If you understand, let's say you have your cell phone, and they say as long as you dial the number, you put it on and dial the number, it's supposed to ring, or the person's phone is supposed to ring. But you put it on, it don't ring. The person's not getting a call, you're not getting through to them. And when you listen, you may hear that you may not, you can't make calls from this device. Because you had a falling out with GT&T or Digicel. It means something that was supposed to be to make this thing happen was not in order, so to speak. If you don't have credit in your phone, even though you have the correct number, you won't get through. Okay? Or perhaps you dial the number, but the code you put in is the wrong code. You have the right number, the wrong code. You won't get through. So this is not working in isolation. It means you saw the one since I had not speak it. And he said, by their words they're justified, by words they're condemned. So our words will determine if you're justified or condemned. But, and then he further says in Mark 11:23, what is that? Who remember that? That's 24, 23. You don't remove the cars in the sea. Now, clearly you see something there, and the major factor is heart. I want you to turn with me, please, in your Bible, to the book of Rome, Proverbs chapter 23. We want to read from verse 6 to 8, please.
Proverbs chapter 23, verse 6. Eat thou not the bread of him that hath a feeble head, neither desire thou his dainty meats. For as he thinketh in his heart, so is he. Eat and drink, saith he to me, but his heart is not with thee. The morsel which thou hast eaten shall thou vomit up, and lose thy sweet words.
Amen. Eat not the bread of him that hath an evil eye. Primarily speaking of the greedy man. Eat not thou the bread of him that hath an evil eye. Neither desire thou his dainties. Said, for as he thinketh in his heart, that's where we want to go to, as he thinketh in his heart, so is he. Now this man is saying one thing, but his heart is saying another. Guess what, which one is more powerful? But it's in his heart. Because the scripture says, his words are, hey, enjoy, man. Enjoy, you had enough. Eat, go ahead, take some more. But his heart, he's thinking of yours. His torment. Or his pest. You understand? His words are different. Ultimately, what prevails is what is in his heart. So, we understand the principle of there's death and life in the power of the tongue. We understand that by words you're justified, by words you're condemned. We understand it. But those words must originate in the heart, because what is in the heart is more dominant than what you say. So what may be saying, might be saying, I've been confessing something, but I'm not seeing anything happening. Because what we're confessing with our mouths, our hearts are not like of it. Our thoughts were not the same. Your heart is the seat of your thinking. So our thoughts were not the same as what we were saying. This tells us that the most powerful are your thoughts. Because the words are only effective when they are in harmony with what you're thinking. You follow? Words are only effective when they are in harmony or they originate from the heart. Let me say it again. Let me give you an example. Here's somebody saying, money coming to me speedily, abundantly, frequently, and easily. How are you making a confession? Your money coming to me speedily, abundantly. Okay. But in your heart, you're thinking, I know the next dollar coming from right now. But if you believe that in your heart, and somebody used to say to you, please give me $1,000. What is your heart? You jump up. If in your heart you believe money coming to you, speed up on the free, and somebody says, quickly, I have $1,000. And you only have $2,000. You can say, sure. You can even give them two. If somebody called you and told you, you know what, I'm on my way, somebody sent $1,000 for you, I'm bringing it. It to you. Right now I'm in the bus bringing it. And somebody used to say, could you lend me $1,000 and your last $1,000? The person told you that you can depend on their word. Would you lend them $1,000? You said, I take it, don't worry about it. Why? Now somebody from a bus give you a word which you believe and you can't believe your own word. It means that really and truly, even though we say it in our hearts, we don't believe it. And only what we think. So regardless of what we say, I don't want me to first take it in isolation where I say the confession. Why we say it, we have to affirm it and confess it over and over, is so that our heart will get it. So it may dwell abundantly in our hearts. Not I met a preacher once, right? Then I met him, I knew the guy. The old guy told me that. The guy tell me he really don't even believe the Bible. Not a pastor. I see he don't believe the Bible. I said, what? He's preaching the Bible really trying to believe the Bible. Guess what happened? What would happen in his preaching? It'd be ineffective. Because what his mouth is saying, his heart is does not believe. If your mouth saying one thing and it's not in your heart, even the words you speak, they are not effective. Because only what originates in your heart, only what you believe, if you say it, is potent. So do we confess it? Yes, we confess it. But understand this. The confession is for me now. The affirmation, I affirm it. Until it is firmly fixed inside of me. This was for me. I firmly fix the statement inside of my heart. So my mouth overflows naturally with it. When it's fixed, when my mouth overflows naturally with it, so I say, what are you doing? I say, or would you say, my God, right now, things are tough. I don't know where the next dollar coming from. When it's firmly fixed inside of us, then somebody said, God, that's why I said to do, he said, money coming. Or you're going to give, or you're going to lend somebody, do something to somebody, and the thought comes, He's been doing that, you know where you're getting money from. And God will come to you. Money God, all right, money come. We have to fix this in our minds. So what we meditate on it. We meditate on it day and night. Over and over and over and over and over. We confess it over and 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 over. We are affixed in our hearts. Because only what comes from your heart that you say will have any effect. You hear that? Only what comes from the words are powerful, but from this understanding, thoughts are more powerful than words. But the Bible says, as he thinketh in his heart. Because a man is saying, eat, man, you want some more? You had enough, you should have had enough. Take some more, you know. You can have some more. And look at you. You sure? Yeah, it's all right. And the Bible says you'll vomit it up. In other words, his thinking will affect the food that you will vomit it up.
Yes.
What he thinks. What he's thinking, what a person is thinking. That's why if somebody is not disposed or don't feel good, I don't even want him to give me a glass of water. If you have a negative attitude, I don't even want to give me a glass of water. Not even that. You will tarnish it. I prefer buy the bottle of water. You know why? Because when I pay the man, whatever is his attitude, I made an exchange. I have to get water because he took money. So it's foolishness not coming in that water because I bought it. I made an exchange. Like what I bought, I get. So whatever he was thinking, he can't think because he didn't give me anything, I bought it. If I asked you for a drink of water and you have a negative thought, and I realize it, I don't want it from your hand. That's why when in the book of Genesis, when the king fell to the baker or the butler that stole them, he said, put him in prison, I don't want him to give me anything. Then discovered who the culprit was. Told him the one was restored, and he said, you'll be restored, and he was restored. So he said, I don't mind what they're thinking. I eat their food, I don't care what they think is. That's why you guys get some certain problems. And afterwards, they said, I'm still going on. That's fierce. So I don't know, it's like.
Yes.
Yes, it's like,
I feel this pain.
Okay. It's your system trying to vomit it up. You think you have your own broke stomach, right? So we say I have your own gross stomach and I don't vomit. The body vomits in various ways. You know the body vomits? When you see boys break out in your face, vomit your body vomiting. It's getting rid of things that are not supposed to be in there. Your thoughts are powerful. You know, as I got up to hear a lot on the subject, I began to look at some scientific research on thoughts. Listen, they've discovered that thought has energy. And my thoughts really and truly generate energy. Energy is what? Give me a definition for energy. We learned it already in school. The ability to do work, right?
Yes.
The ability to do what?
Work.
The ability to do what?
Work.
Say it again, say the ability to do?
Work.
What energy does?
The ability to do.
Energy does work. So energy has the ability to do work. Right? Energy has the ability to do what?
Work.
In the world we live, people work. Do you realize that people are rewarded more who do mental work than who do physical work?
Yes, sir.
Because mental work produces more. One man put it, if you can't work at mine, tell me you know the rest of the story. So the person who works the mind are rewarded more than the person who works the hands. Now look at this, look at this, look at this. Since thought and energy has the ability to work, you know how much work your thoughts can do for you? And you will be rewarded more than the physical work you put in. Because it does work in that. There's not what energy does. So thoughts are energy. That's what they are. Energy, it's energy. Actually, it's energy. So, you need a car, and you can physically work to get a car. Or Jesus says, whatsoever things you desire, think about it. Think it to be true. That's working. That's working. I discovered thinking a thing to be true is work, which most times we are. And we've been programmed to use the basic system. So I want to do physical work. So rather than taking 5 minutes every day and thinking without mental energy, you say, I'm gonna use physical energy. Which one brings a greater reward? Mental energy. The world is around us shows us. The Bible tells us that. The Bible tells us that. And here what we do with mental energy. You have all these bills, I have these bills at the end of the month, I have the end of the week, so something better come, it's not like we can't pay these bills. We take the mental energy and declare we can't pay bills. And that mental energy will create the situation. Yes. Somebody intended to call you, will not call you.
Yes.
Because you created a situation you can't pay bills. So that must be a reality. And it's the same thing I say. I'm here to pay the bill. I know this will happen. Now, the broader thing then, the secret, is the Bible stop the thing. You know what they did? They plagiarized on the scripture. That's what the devil did. In the book of Genesis, the Bible says what did the Egyptians do? The word?
Spoiled
Egyptian. But listen, the Egyptian was spoiling the kingdom. Yes. Because God says, meditate on the day and night. God says, all those things that be not as though they were. God says whatever things you desire, believe you receive and shall have it.
Yes.
And you have preachers saying, don't believe in this name and claim the thing. We didn't say this, God said that.
Amen.
And preachers saying, this foolish is my name and claim it. You gotta go out and work for what you want. And God says whatever things you desire, believe you receive it and shall have it. And we take our energy and think ourselves into poverty. And think ourselves into lack, and think ourselves into problems. Now we can take the same energy and think ourselves into victory. thought, what is the thoughts?
Thoughts.
My thoughts, you see, and it's not anybody else's thoughts. It's your thoughts, our thoughts. The Bible says, whatsoever things are, what?
Pure.
What scripture?
Yes.
Is Philippians?
Philippians chapter 4.
Philippians chapter 4. Please find a scripture. Somebody said, what you think about, you bring about. Well, that's scriptural. And this is why God warns us through the word of God, what we should think about. Philippians chapter 4.
Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on such things.
Meditate on such things. Think on such things. Because, beloved, I saw this guy did on television. The experiment is on TV, if you YouTube, you can see it. This guy did something. Now we all have what they call a magnetic field around us. Everybody has it. And the guy showed that he had this girl as a subject. When she entertained negative thoughts, her magnetic field shrunk down to 2 feet, or 2 feet. But he has this thing that he walks up, and as soon as he enters her magnetic field, it raises up, so you know she's entered her magnetic field, right? So when she was having just neutral thoughts, not thinking anything bad or negative, it was at about 10 feet away. 10 feet or more, the magnetic field. In other words, this thing, imagine this phone has a field around it. Now, if it has negative thoughts, it shrinks it. If you don't have any negative thought, it's about this wide, this distance away, about 10 feet away, the magnetic field is. When she entertained positive thoughts, it's about 20 feet away. So he has this thing walking in. So he has to entertain positive thoughts. 20 feet, she come in contact with the magnetic field. So a person who always entertaining negative thoughts, guess what you're doing? You're destroying yourself. Because think of your magnetic field as your world. And you're shooting all these negative thoughts which come back bouncing back to you in your small world. People don't like me. Whatever it is. Things not working for me. Things not good. Things terrible. As you entertain all those negative thoughts, they are coming back. And they're making diseases in your body. Thoughts of hatred and anger and unforgiveness, they make you sick. Whereas thoughts of happiness and peace and joy and love, wide. When people are dead, that aura disappears. Now think of it. The person who's full of life has a big aura. Mm-hmm. And the one who is negative has a small aura, not far from the body. Mm-hmm. They're close to death. Or they're killing themselves, they're dying. Mm-hmm. Persons who make it a duty and entertain negative thoughts, and they like it and they boast with it. And slow poisoning themselves.
Mm-hmm. Jesus.
With your own thoughts. That's for thought, isn't that so? The Bible says we have the capacity or the power to think of what we want to think about. Or else God would say, whatsoever things are lovely, what's the thing on those things? If it was, we don't have the capacity to say what we think about. No. Well, this thought come in my mind. Let me tell you, I've discovered you can't think about two things at the same time. And you don't Say, well, let me push the thought out. Please don't try to push thoughts out. Don't waste your energy. Think of something else. Hello? Let's say, let me use a young lady. This young lady, a thought comes to your mind. I wonder my boyfriend or my fiance or my husband. He must be doing something. Change it to, he's buying me flowers. He's getting something nice. And he's thinking about me right now. How lovely I am. Hello?
Very good. Very good.
Somebody didn't hear from him for a while. I had like the spirit gone from me. They drop me. Someone must tell him something of me. You know what I'm saying? I like somebody that can hear a talk in him. Say to yourself, they're thinking with me. You understand? You know, most people, you get married, you get into a relationship, say, you know what, you see me? I can left this. That's what I think all the time. You have a choice, you can choose what thoughts you entertain. You can't stop a bird from, it says, you can't stop a bird from flying over your head. You can't even start from lighting from your, in your, on your head, unawares, but you can prevent from building a nest. Am I right? We can stop from building a nest. We can't stop a bird. Because thoughts will come uninvited, will flow up, whether for more reasoning or whatever. It's what we meditate on becomes potent. You eat fish, and it may have bones. It's only what you chew that go into your stomach. So you find bones, you strip them up. But you don't stop eating, you just continue the flesh. That's what we do. Well, so a thought comes. It's not a thought I want, but I don't fight with it. I think on something positive. Whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are good report. If there be any virtue, think on these things. You know, some people have some friends. Anything happens on the news, they know. Their Facebook go off. Because their phone is set to hear those things. Like, listen. So if somebody put up, I feel like killing myself, then the point is, get interested in good news.
Amen.
Yes.
So whatsoever things are pure, think on those things. Now sometimes, you ever stay and something cross your mind and you start feeling sad? Yes. Because a thought crossed your mind?
Yes.
The thing didn't happen, not necessarily true, but your whole sink. And you're worrying about something that just crossed your mind can happen. Mm-hmm. Suppose it happened. What do you do? What do you do?
Think something else.
Don't say, well, that can't happen. No, that can't happen. Nothing can happen. Don't fight with that. Think of something good that happened. That will happen. See something good that happened. Okay. Sing some happy song.
Yes.
And soon that will disappear out of your mind.
Yes.
Encourage yourself in the Lord. Encourage yourself in the Lord. The Lord is the strength of my life.
Yes.
Whatever scripture you can remember, encourage yourself with the goodness of our Father. Oh, He loves me, Father loves me. Amazing grace. God loves me so much.
Amen.
So you just gotta, you gotta do yourself, you see. Mm-hmm. And then, and after a while, you become a happy person. Mm-hmm. Get in the habit of smiling, be cheerful. Some people, they have a pack of covenant to their face. I will not smile, I won't even talk. I am determined to be like this. I joke past, I say, why are you cracking up over here? Don't jump somebody, say, relax, man. Relax your face. Listen to me. People say, hey, you don't know what I'm going through right now. Excuse me. Everybody going through something.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
Amen. Amen.
And you even if you're going through it.
True.
We won't build a gap. What a gap. Pass through. We can't be notable.
Amen.
Let me tell you, I don't care what situation you're in, but right on the laugh about it.
Yes. 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 Yes.
Praise God.
And you can laugh.
Yeah.
Laugh the best medicine.
Amen.
And some people don't like medicine from smile. Some people, I don't know if God says the best medicine. Some people, like, they think of medicine as the best thing you want to give it, set them apart. So you give them a joke. I will not laugh. You know, some people like to run. You think I laugh? You laugh. Some people say, no, see me and me want to laugh. Beloved, whatsoever things are pure, thinkable. Because at the end of the day, your thoughts, listen to me, produce energy. Your thought. You're saying about energy. There's something about energy. You can't create it. You can't destroy it. You can't create energy, you can't destroy energy. It's forever changing. You can change form.
Yes.
You can't destroy it. You can't create it. It's God did that.
Amen.
What we can do, we can direct it.
Yes.
We have the power to direct energy. We direct energy in our words. When we speak, we are directing energy. But that it must be forced in our heart. That's how we can direct it. So when you speak, you are directing energy. And you know, you can have one of the water there. And the energy goes and does work.
Yes.
Say it does work.
Does work.
Can do more work than you can do.
Can do more work than you can do.
So, think. How much energy you spend, how much energy we use thinking negative things. You know what energy we use up thinking negative things that people don't like us and people doing this and people doing that. And the temptation comes to all of us, beloved. At the end of the day, it's what we do with it. What we do with the thoughts. We don't feel bad just like that unless somebody you experience some physical pain. You have to listen. You have to prepare yourself to feel bad. You don't know that? To go into depression, you have to put yourself a certain way. You have to hold your head a certain way. And if sin makes you face, that is slow. You have to make sure to song. And I don't know the song right, you guys. You're building up to the word. Right now you can sing a happy song. You can see things are getting better. Yeah. Even things are already better. For the Lord is on my side. You know, I wish my Lord to sing myself.
Yes.
Out of any state of depression.
Wonderful.
No, I sing a happy song. Do thoughts come short? Sure. Scary thoughts come. I can dwell on them. I'm go crazy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because next I start worrying. And worry don't change anything. Or I can say, okay, I will take my energy. Because to worry is energy.
Yes.
You're using energy to work against you.
That's right.
Because you're creating a world. Worry, you're creating a world, a negative one. Mm-hmm. Or you can just use it and create a positive thing.
Yes.
It's a positive future, which is going to manifest for you and benefit you. As a man thinking,
so
in time.
So is
he.
So is he.
Not as he speak it, as he think it. When we speak, we release energy. But energy is only released when what we say comes from our heart. Now we can understand why when Isaac wanted to bless his son, he said, well, make me savory food, me ministers that I love, and I may eat, and my soul or my heart may bless you. Because if he didn't do that, there was no energy in what he would have said.
Yes.
So I can put my hand here and say, Lord bless and keep your cards to Israel, shine in your life, and come be with you. Please, amen. You understand? Imagine somebody come to me and say, please bless me. God bless you. We're so rich. Or somebody come to me and say,
look.
You ain't smiling. I mean, you're coming with joy and I bless you because you touched my heart. You may not give maybe a beautiful smile or the way you come in. You understand? So he said to Esau, and guess what? No, I'm thinking, see, the father would be aware that Esau said his birthright, you know?
Yes.
And say, you know, he moved to bless him. Because observe, Jacob didn't ask Joseph for anything. Because what Joseph had done, he was moved to bless him, to bless Joseph. Here we tell Reuben, if he was looking when he blessed his son.
Mm-hmm. Unstable as water.
Yeah. And then he had committed that thing.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you may say, Esau is evil. You know, he went to Esau.
Yes.
Say, well, go back, me say, bring me some of his heart and move on, bless you.
Uh-huh.
So, some people to get blessed, they all bring savory meat.
Yeah.
They get a blessing.
Yeah.
Some people, they have been offering savory meat for so long that Do we want to bless them? You can just, like the Shulamite woman, the prophet, man of God says, go call her woman.
Yes.
So what do you want me to do for you? She was careful, you're telling me that I'm scared. What do you want me to do for you? Because here's the man of God. She said, build a room for him and everything. And whatever time he come in, and you don't understand, you ain't look at the scripture, they've been caring for us with all this care. Because let's say she provide chow mein and say everything, you know, they ain't feel like chow mein. I go, what can I do for you? Somebody said, really, they're good. I mean, you're nothing else, you're not chow mein, you're sleepy.
No.
Do you understand? But the woman cared for him.
Yeah.
With all whatever care. He said, I got still something for you, man. So, what do you want me to do for you? He said, nothing. You want me to speak to the kids? I don't. She had to bring anything. She had done so much. And then the sovereign said, you know, she don't have any children, her husband is old. He said, call her back. Send you a child.
Amen.
You understand?
Yes.
Because your heart wants to bless. Your heart wants to say something. Some people provoke you. You they don't open your mouth. Because you open your mouth, you sit around. You bless your course. You understand? Some people put you in a place like that. If they put your head, put the head to for you, they might say something terrible. They bring me, say, bring me. So my heart, because we love you, is what the what compose against in the heart that is powerful and potent.
Yes.
Not the mouth, the heart. Then we have to cultivate thoughts by doing what? By things that are pure. I hear the Lord just to you. Somebody said cultivate your heart.
Cultivate your heart.
Yeah. You're sowing seeds in your heart that will bring forth fruit. How do we sow seeds in our heart? The things we consciously think about, meditate on, we are sowing. So what happens? After a while, only those things will come up. If forever my greatest interest is in go and sit, then some will get it again next week. Some of you like to go sit. Gossip. Well, that's what will happen. And guess what happened? You always find your gossipers will attract you be attracted to gossip. You are interested in an understanding of the word, you'll find people who are interested that will be attracted to you. And you'll meet them. You're interested in doing business and increasing in business, those will be attracted to you. You'll meet them. It's true. They'll all be calling you up and giving you opportunities and all because you're interested in that.